run type of thing. So that's another option that we have against this. And I'm just going to close that off and change that back to the same size again. Okay. So the drag and drop is actually fairly easy and fairly equivalent to what we used to have in the Doors world. Now, one of the things I talked about was that D&G much better supports, I would say, collaboration across the domains, across the disciplines. So with test, with development, etc. So just as we could have created those links over here by drag and drop, I can also create those links over to other items. So for example, when you click on my more list, what I actually want to do is I want to go on, let's say, what's the right one I want to do? Let me think here. Test plan? I guess we could probably do that type. Now, for whatever reason, mine is not going to want to. And I don't know why. I have a feeling that I broke something. Nope, there we go. So validated by, for example. So if I want to do validated by, it's going to go to my quality management. And I can either link to an existing test plan test case, or even from this window, I can choose to go create a new one. So I can create a whole new test plan or a test case. I can use a template. And the same thing if I wanted to link this requirement to a work item. I want somebody to track who's going to build this, when, how, what, etc. You can see that that linkage is the traceability extends not just across the requirements, but it can extend into the other aspect of the life cycle, depending on, you know, what you have and what you're working with. The scope of going through work items, test plans, etc. is out of the scope of this, but I want to show you at least there was that capability. Okay. So far, I've been working with the majority of these in module view, the thing that most of us would be used to seeing. Okay? But you can also work with the requirements in what we call the artifacts view. So all of those artifacts, remember I said back in during the slides that they had to live somewhere, and they had to live in a folder. So all of those stakeholder requirements, as an example, all exist within inside of that folder. And I can control who has access to that folder, okay, by assigning ownership to that folder. And I can control who's allowed to see, modify those requirements. And that's where we would typically have start controlling that security. Now, one of the things that's also useful inside of here, notice the same type of look and feel. So if I want to have different columns displayed, I can turn off the columns that I don't want. I can keep the artifact type in this case. Maybe, let's see, what else do we want to have? Maybe we'll have something else. Let's grab something else in here. Let's go back and grab the priority again. I think that was in here.
While you do that, I want to let the attendees know that I'm getting a lot of questions submitted now, and I have Rick Learn, who's also on our team, that's going to help answer some of these questions. And what I'm going to do is reply to the attendees, hopefully with an answer. If you don't hear from me through the online Q&A chat with an answer, what will happen is that I will ping you when I'll ask the question directly to Ian, so that you're aware to kind of, you know, perk up and be ready for the answer. So just understand that a lot of questions are now rolling in, and that I'm going to try to get to all of them if we can, either through the chat, or I'll let you know when I'll submit it to Ian during Q&A. So I apologize again for the interruption, and you can move forward.
Okay, cool. So just very quickly, showing that very much like this world, if I want to edit an attribute directly on the spot, I can go and do that just by opening, clicking in the column, very similar to what I would do in the Doors world. One of the other capabilities that you have inside here is that if I wanted to go change, let's say, several of these all at once, and I'm going to change a whole bunch of these, and maybe they're even non-contiguous, I can select whichever set that I'm looking for. Then basically you have the ability to edit attributes for these five artifacts. So in this particular case, I'm going to change the priority. I'm going to make everybody medium at one go. And I'm going to go save that. Hopefully everybody was able to see that. So there's a lot of actions that you can perform directly on multiple or single attributes as well. Okay. Another option that you might want to do, and we talked about this a little bit, was if you had a whole number of different requirements that I want to track, let's say, the work against, these are all the ones that are intended for release one, release whatever. Okay. When I have a highlighted list like this, another option that I might want to do, and I'll go through all of the ones that I have in here, but I might want to add all of these to a collection, for example, because I would like to try and track these as a unit and say, these are the things that we're planning for release one, planning for release two. So I can take all of those and say, I'm going to add those to a collection. Okay. So I'm just going to say, this is release one as an example. Okay. Which for the other extra. And I have to create a new artifact because I don't have one. Let's try that again. Apparently I didn't save my last collection. Good, good, good. Great. So now I have a collection that I can actually will actually contain all of these. Now, besides doing the collection, one of the other things that I can do is I can add something to the What I can also add this to is, let's say, a review. So if I wanted to, I could say, you know what, I want these in a review, because I need comments back from somebody. I can make that formal or informal. We won't go into the details of those in this. Need to confirm these with customer. And where did it go? There we go. Okay. So now I have these things under review. Very good. I can add a participant, in fact, need to, so I'm going to add in that rational user, and I'm just using everybody's rational today to make this easy. Okay, save the review and start the review. Good. Now that I'm in here, let's go back to our project dashboard again for a moment. Let's go back to our detailed info for a moment. So right off the bat, we see that we have recent changes. So some of the things that we've been modifying, the links, et cetera, and we can go look at that. We can see that we have something that's under review right now, and we can even see what the status of that review is. It's just been started and nothing has been reviewed. And there you can see the three artifacts that I had added to the fly. I neglected to go through and add any comments or show you the commenting, but you can see that if I had added any comments, I would have seen those are the comments in that thread of discussions here as well. So let's go into the module views of the view itself to implement information. If I build my dashboard with the right widgets, I can see that information at a moment's glance. So I'm conscious that we've been over the top of the hour. There's not a lot to show with Invoice Next Generation. It's exceptionally powerful. So I think with that, I would probably like to start getting to questions and thank everybody for their patience. This way, we've got some time to answer questions back and forth and maybe show additional things about the tool if there are specific questions that come up. So thank you, Mark.
Oh, great. Thanks. Can you hear me okay, Ian?